Anti-Afro Svengalis, listen, everyone, I just wanted to make sure you all were aware of the other aspects that Glorion Murray has perpetrated here in these YouTube streets. And the reason why I made a point to play this video, because I find it the epitome of insult that Glorion Murray tries her damnedest to present herself in a morally upstanding manner, but she claims it's to my detriment. This is called character hijacking. You are the one, Glorion Murray, who's going around these YouTube streets acting as if you have no semblance of self-control in any area of your life. So I'm just reminding you that you're not gonna be able to compare me to you, and you're never gonna be able to try to hijack my character without me coming for you. This includes Glorion Murray telling me I need to be taking drugs. Glorion Murray has come on these YouTube streets telling people that she's in recovery. She's in recovery and she's telling me I need to take drugs. Listen, you are the one that has an immoral, amoral existence here on these YouTube streets. And the more we find out about you, we recognize there is no difference between what you're doing here on YouTube and in the real world. So we're moving on.
I don't give a fuck about them bums over on that side on YouTube.
Gloria, girl, they got you over there charged with looking up her medical records. The only one. The correct one. And you got fired from your job because you were messing with her medical records. She said that, Gloria, you did it.
According to them, I've been fired.
She said you got a hold of her medical records. I was like, I don't think Glorion works in a medical center. So you say you.
I guess they never heard of HIPAA laws. I don't got time for listening to them getting me fired from the same job 10 times this year. See, people be lying so freaking much, they don't realize that their lies sound retarded at this point.
Yeah. Glorion Murray, we are talking about that job that you've been saying that we said you were fired from 10 times. You know good and damn well you have gone through multiple hearings. You know this. And you also know that you have a 20-page document stating specifically that you're fired. Now, I hope I never ever hear you talk any shit about Rev G, who is the person who pushed the hardest to not have the location of this document placed. Although it's public information, clearly there are people who don't know how to locate it. You were the one that's been going around telling lie after lie after lie. Now, let me back up, people. Why is this happening? Why are you doing this to Glorion Murray? I can't believe she's picking on me. I still don't know what I did. That's the bullshit that she's been saying for a year. She's been going around to all these platforms telling lie after lie after lie after lie. And we just sat back listening to all of these lies, wondering just how far you were going to take these lies, Glorion Murray. And not only that, she wants you all to believe this is over a live stream, over Lennon Honor's live stream, over what happened in someone else's live stream, who I'm making a specific point not to mention, because I have not heard this person mentioning my name lately. So I'm not going to even bring up this individual. But these are the two things that Glorion Murray and Bernice, excuse me, butthole pick Bernice, is going around these YouTube streets spreading these lies, either through these messages or getting up on these demon-infused panels and lying straight through their teeth. What the heck am I talking about? Yes, this does relate to what's going on with Me Three and Minds, AKA The Only One. Now, I cannot help but refer to Me Three and Minds as The Only One because that's how I've known her since August 2020 when we first connected and have stayed connected all through the conflicts with the smoke. The Only One and I have been checking in with each other. And I'm going to tell you how this is all related. How am I involved? Let me stop because I want to give attention to this message you see here on the screen. This is one of the examples of the many, many, many messages that Glorion Murray has left. Not just her, this butthole pick Bernice has left in these various live streams about me. Someone says, someone else says first, I was rolling when Bernice confirmed AAS got kicked out of blank, basically. Basically, now this was when butthole pick Bernice did that ridiculous interview that's been scrubbed from Let Me See Your Handcuffs page. Isn't that interesting? It went poof. The surviving AAS. Why? Because she's not surviving AAS. But this is something that another person has stated. And then you see Glorion Murray come and say, you get trashed on a live. That's how you know when you got kicked out. I was never trashed on a live. Trashed? When was that? Somebody came on and gave a 95% praise, acknowledgement, recognition, confirmation of what I stated, and 5% because the person thought I was speaking for the individual and said some other things that didn't agree. I hardly call that trashing. What you have here is this get her, which would be towards me. They want somebody else to get me. Why don't you do it? Why don't you do it? I'll tell you the short answer on both accounts. There's no justification for anybody to drag me because I'm simply defending myself. Take a look at this. This is the kind of shit I'm talking about. And somebody's going to drag me for defending myself or trash me. You got butthole pick Bernice calling me a dog. You got Glorion Murray spreading all these lies about me. If anybody tries to come up here in the YouTube space to drag me behind defending myself, you're going to see me swinging like you've never seen before. And it's all going to go right back to butthole pick Bernice and Glorion. Now, if I have to deal with the other person, I'll deal with that. But nothing transfers from any host that they are in a live stream under to them. Nothing about a host I'm taking with me when it comes to you. I'm getting you individually. You don't have any clout that's going to back me off of defending myself with nobody here on YouTube, anywhere. All the shit these people have been doing, not only to me, but to other people, and you think you're going to get some coverage or some defense? Are you going to take refuge? Sticking up for your bullshit? Not when it comes to me. I stated it before. I have to state it again. I will. I don't have any fear when it comes to defending myself and my character. Your character is trash. There is no way in hell you're going to sit here and elevate yourself above me after the crap that you have been doing. Criminal conduct. You are engaging in criminal conduct. You're hell no, you're not going to put me beneath you when it comes to character. And what makes it worse is that they want to push this scenario that I was kicked out. How am I kicked out? I didn't go back. Isn't being kicked out when you go back to a place and then you get in there and then they say, you are blocked or get out of here or whatever. Isn't there some big grand production? That never happened. It took how long for them to make this claim that I was blocked? And I actually had left messages on the community page of this person and they said I was blocked. I don't know. I'm not making a big deal about it. They're making a big deal about it. And check this out. They're the ones that come stalking me to other spaces. I have never, ever left a space and went back to the space and stalked and harassed somebody. So there is no way in hell anybody's going to come up here and drag me for anything. I'm up here in the self-defense position. You can't drag me for being in the self-defense position. That doesn't make any sense, but they want it so bad. They're desperate. They'll pay for me to be dragged. They'll do anything they can because they're gutless and they know they have no justification to do jack shit to me. They are the aggressors. They are the criminals who I insist be held accountable, and I'm gonna pursue that to the ends of the earth.